All good, ma'am. Just preparing for this.
Okay, so let's start with your introduction. Just introduce yourself briefly and walk me through your CV.
Yeah, so ma'am, I'm Abhidip Tripathi. I'm a final year student at BITS Pilani, right now pursuing my mechanical degree. I have been in various positions of responsibility, such as the acting president of the campus, the regional association president, and a few other stuff like skating captain. I have contributed to the campus a lot. In the meanwhile, I have also my inclination in web technologies and data analytic fields. I have gone through few of the courses externally, not in my academics, because I didn't get the choice to pick those courses. So few of them were data analytics and using Python and R. I have done it from Coding Ninja. There's a site called Coding Ninja, which is very well renowned for it. And one of them being Hindi Education. Apart from data analytic field, ma'am, I have also great exposure in web technologies. I have more than 3 projects in web fields, which has actually solved real life problems on our campus. And I see myself, I have also gone through courses like supply chain management, product planning and control, and engineering optimization. So I find myself somewhere in between the intersection of the field of business, data, and technology. So that's why I feel I'll land here.
Okay. So you have done a course, supply chain management, right?
Yes, ma'am.
What exactly did you cover in that course?
Ma'am, in supply chain management, we went through various strategies locally and globally, how you basically optimize the supply chain cost, which greatly affects the whole chain. So starting from the production chain to the retailer chain, everything that comes between has each processes in between. So defining those bullet points in detail to optimize the whole cost of the supply chain was the major motive of the course.
Okay, so have you heard of economic order quantity?
Yes, ma'am.
EOQ?
The Q-star.
What?
Q-star.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. That's that's the quantity that you should order to optimize on your costs. Like you have holding costs, and you also have one, you have the holding cost, and the other you need to look up to meeting the expectations of the demand. So keeping both of them at mind, there is a optimum quantity that you need to order, and that's the quantity, optimal quantity, order quantity.
Okay, fine. So Abhidip, can you tell me what do you do in your free time? I mean, your hobbies or interests? How exactly do you plan your schedule?
Ma'am, honestly, I would say when I was on campus, there was nothing of free time for me. Every time it used to be, you know, here and there, few things. Like I used to rise up with the thought that I don't know what's going to happen today. Every day used to be something new for me. So that was a bit challenging. As well as if you come to the hobbies, what I like to do is skating. I have a few interests in solving Kaggle competitions. So I go through them, but I'm not very proficient till now, but I definitely see myself being good at that.
Okay, fine. Abhidip, what exactly do you know about the role of business development?
Ma'am, I feel that business development officer will be someone who will be contributing to the growth of the business in all manner possible. It can be in form of marketing. It can be in form of analyzing the data to contribute. It can be in other sorts of channel where the company needs you.
Okay, fine. So you talked of marketing,
yes,
right?
Ma'am.
I'll give you a task. You have to sell me a cup of coffee.
Okay.
So just take some time, take 30 seconds or take a minute to think how would your pitch go, and then just sell me a cup of coffee.
Just a minute. Can I go ahead, ma'am?
Yeah.
Yeah, so ma'am, I guess that's a lovely warm, lovely cold morning there. So what's best thing you can have with you while you're interviewing me? I guess it's a coffee besides you, right? So right now you have the coffee, but you don't have the cup. I'll give you that. I'll give you the best cup, which actually, you know, you'll give that warm to you. And as always, the coffee would taste better in that to sip. And apart from that, who knows that that coffee might actually convert my interview to a placement offer. So yeah, I would definitely like you to have one.
Okay. So why not tea and why coffee?
I guess the corporate culture believes more in coffee than tea.
Okay. Fine. I'll take your word for that. Okay. So you must have, faced a conflict or an argument. There must be an argument with a friend of yours or a colleague, batchmate. So can you just give me an instance of that situation and how you solve that?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, this goes very deep in all kind of event management things, ma'am, which I have come across. What I feel when this situation arises, both the parties are never actually wrong about the thing. For example, I'll give you a point. We were having this... Durga Puja celebration. So I was leading the team to get that thing in our campus. So we had a great pandal and all kind of organizations, all kind of items, pujari, pandits, all kind of things there. So I divided the team so that each task can be done completely with a budget constraint. Okay, now the point is, how much should I allot to each team? This is where the conflict arised, right? So who's getting more and who's getting less? So according to my belief, I said that the decoration might be a little ill, that doesn't matter. But the tradition in which the puja is done, that should be well. So all kind of samagris, all kind of pandits, you need to invest there more than any kind of decoration, because ultimately it's on campus, it has some value. But you need to get the primary task completed first, then anything else. But few of them were like, no, this is not the way. Ultimately, it's, they had a different thought about it, that the puja was not to celebrate, it's to show the people around you. So this is where the basic conflict was. So how do you solve it is you find the main root problem where the conflict is arising. You sit there, you put on your heads, and then you make the other person, or you realize yourself that whatever you're doing, is it right or wrong? Then you'll come to a solution. That's what I feel.
Okay, fine.
I have done that every time, and it has given me good results.
Okay, makes sense. Okay, Abhidev, I'll give you a situation and you need to tell me how you would respond to it. Okay, so for example, you have a client who is willing to switch to one of your competitors. Okay. And just tell me, how would you respond to that situation? How would you handle it?
First, I would, I'll just take a minute to summarize what I'm thinking.
Take time.
Okay, so I'll first think that, why is he switching? What is the main reason why he's switching? What value is he adding to the company? Is it worth that he can go and will have some kind of replacement? Is that possible? Then I'll think that the problems he's facing here and the problems that is getting resolved there. So after knowing all these things, if that person is worth that efforts, worth my efforts, then I'll make sure that I do all kind of possible measures to keep him here by solving the exact problem, by getting to first know what exact problem he has, and then trying to solve it in my own possible way with the resources I have. Okay, if that isn't possible, if I can't resolve the exact problem he has, at least I'll land up somewhere between both the things. It isn't solving, but it isn't harming him anymore now. The main reason which I believe he switches the company is might be one of the salary hikes. He's getting a better place. He's getting a better package there, or he's getting a better experience there, or he's not satisfied working here. So what exactly? Each of the problem has a different approach to go through, right? So I'll be pinpointing that exact problem and I'll be trying to solve it in all possible ways I can, if that person is worth the time.
Okay, so when you say worth the kind, what do you mean by that? What do you mean when you say he's adding value or he's worth it? What do you mean by that?
If I am paying him 50,000 and he's bringing back 2 lakhs to the company, then he's adding value to it. If the person is paying, I'm paying is 50,000 and he's getting 60,000 or 70,000, then yes, it is profitable, but I think someone better can land there.
Okay.
And definitely, if he's getting us lost, then he's nowhere in the company, I guess. If the company is smart enough to pick people who can actually add value to them.
Okay, fine. So let's continue with this. Let's just say that the client wants you to add a feature to one of your products, right? Now, what would you do?
Firstly, I'll be glad to know that someone is taking initiative, who's going through the product and actually pointing out the thing. Second, I'll think about what exactly is it going to bring to the company, what are the advantages, what are the disadvantages. It again depends upon in which role I am and which authorities, what kind of power I have in my purview. I'll talk to the concerned authority, all the stakeholders. I'll let him present his idea to the stakeholders. Then we'll have a discussion on it. And there will be some disadvantages to it. So there will be again a process to solve those and then come up with a refined solution. And if everything goes well, then yes, we'll implement it. Or else we'll just keep in mind when what else can be added to launch it in future.
Okay, so what stakeholders are you talking about?
Stakeholders. It's a solution which involves technical team, design team, and the content team. Generally, if something is being added, these are the teams which will be responsible to handle. So is it feasible? Is it feasible by all the team to implement that? Do they think that there is some problem? Where is it? Can we solve it or not? So we need to talk to all the stakeholders. Apart from that, if it's of some great priority, then we might consult even the top executive officials also for that. Yeah.
Okay, fine. Okay, let's just end this case here. Tell me, what are your, say, 3 strengths that you think make you suitable for this role? Any 3 strengths?
Ma'am, I would say my critical thinking, my experience as leading various teams in on campus, and I'll say that I am very clear about what I think and I put that in front of others very clearly. They actually resonate with me when I put my ideas, and they have their minds clear what this guy is talking about. So these are my 3 strengths, I would say.
Okay, fine. Abhiti, last question. What are your future plans? So say, where do you want to see yourself in 5 years?
Ma'am, I'll say that I want to work for the company to contribute as well as to learn. I have never stopped learning. In my entire resume, if you go through, I have explored various fields like web development, data analytics, management, marketing. So I am keen learner, and I'll be learning. And if provided, if the company provides and encourages, then I'll also like to go for a higher study and come back to the company to contribute. And in 5 years, I want myself to be better than today. That's what I would say, much better than today. Living a good life and a knowledgeable life.
Okay, fine. So I think we can end it here. I'll give you a quick feedback and then we can have your questions. Fine?
Okay.
So we started with your introduction and your CV. I think that was okay. Good. Not very long, not very short. You talked about what courses you have done and, you know, every your projects and things. That was okay. After that, I asked you to sell the coffee, right? I think obviously it's very on the spot and you are not very prepared for such things, and it was good. I mean, because I don't, as an interviewer, even I don't expect you to be, you know, perfect at it, because it's not something you practice daily, right? So I think it was good, but of course you can get questions like these in the interviews, right? So
I'll be prepared for that.
Yeah, so at least be confident. You were calm, you were not panicking, you didn't fumble, so that was good. Then of course you cannot be prepared with every product, but there would be a basic pitch that you can be ready with, right? So because, you know, business development does include a lot of roles. It can be marketing, it can be, you know, handling situations, it can be supply chain, everything. So it's just the preparation, basic preparation for such questions. But yeah, I think that's the only thing where you can, you know, work upon. Otherwise it was good. In the situation, I think the approach, okay, it was structured, but I think it lacked some perspective, right? So for example, you started with, you wanted to know why the client wants to switch, what is the problem, whether it's our product or anything else. So that is good. But after that, you can just list down what problems can actually be there. Probably he's not satisfied with the quality that you provide, right? Probably he wants a certain feature in the product, or it can be probably the competitor is giving a better package, a bundled service, something like that, right? So just list down the points so that I know, okay, you are able to think in that perspective also. Okay, you are able to think exhaustively. So that's very important. Even though you know all these things, but just...
I guess I did mention after a while these things. Yeah,
after a while. But again, yeah. It's the...
I need to be structured, yes.
Exactly. That comes with preparation, right? So that's okay. You did mention these points. After that, for example, I said, okay, the client wants a certain feature in the product. Now you talked about the stakeholders, which is good. It can be the product team, it can be, you know, different teams, and the business development team has to communicate with these teams to actually make a decision, right? So that is a very important role of this, or, you know, business development. But again, you could have talked about different challenges that you might face. For example, first point was whether it is possible for us to implement that. Right. So adding a certain feature would require some technical skills, whether that technology is available with us or not. So for that, you'll talk to the, you know, probably R&D team or product team. So that comes, you know, first communication. Then, for example, it can be done. We have the technology to do it. You'll ask yourself whether that client is big enough to actually make such an effort. You talked about whether he's worth it or not, right? So when you say worth it, it's basically the cost benefit analysis. You're putting in some cost to put in that feature. Whether that client brings you that much revenue to recover those costs, that is a question, right? So I think that is one point that you could have mentioned. Then again, stakeholders, yeah, it might be a case that this client wants some XYZ feature in the product, but your other clients do not. Right. So you have to consider other clients as well. If that client is big enough to make that effort, do it. Go ahead with it. But if that client is not very big and your other clients are not really willing to have that feature in the product, just let go. Right. So such decisions come with a lot of, you know, thought into it. Right. So I think it's just the preparation. Just go through such situations, go through such cases, probably on Google or other resources, and you'll just require some practice. Otherwise, I don't think you lack confidence anywhere. You took time to think, which is a very good point. If you just don't, you know, I ask you a question and just don't start talking, you take time to think, and then, you know, that it's always better. It's more structured, yes, whatever you answer. So that is good. Then I think the other two answers, your strengths and, you know, your future plans, that was good. The only thing is preparation. So,
do you think that future plan was a little vague at the end? Or do you think it's good to keep that vague?
Okay.
Because I don't want to say that I want to go for a higher studies and actually end up with some other company. I don't want that.
Yes, you would not want to. The thing is, probably you did not really put in a lot of thought into this question. But yes. I think there are some HR questions like, why business development? Why this role? Right? Because you're switching from engineering to business development. So this is a, you know, a switch.
Because
which
I
is
can
not...
tell them, I have already one internship. I have in marketing in past 5 months. Okay. And apart from that, leadership qualities and all positions I have led, that it's basically the intersection of both the things which makes me suitable for this.
Yes. So the only thing is required is a thought, a lot of thought into these questions. These are very basic questions.
Yes,
the questions like, tell me about yourself, walk me through your CV and your future plan. Say it could have been, where do you want to see yourself in 10 years? Okay. So there, your answer would be a bit different, right? It would be different. Both the answers, right? Then your strengths, what are your weaknesses? These questions are something you have to put a lot of thought, because it's about you, right? It's natural to you, but when you actually have to answer it to an interviewer, it's very different, right? You don't get words immediately. It's better that you are prepared for it.
Am I getting a call?
Yeah.
Sorry. No, my bad. I had it in D&D mode, but still then I got a call, I don't know.
Yeah, it's okay, no problem. Right? So these questions are something you have to just prepare, and you can actually set the pace of the interview based on these questions. Otherwise, I think that's all from me. Any question that you may have?
Ma'am, if you were the real interviewer, would you hire me?
Oh, that's a very difficult question, because obviously I've interviewed you. I have interviewed some of your friends as well. But obviously, that's a very different question.
Yeah. Apart from that, ma'am, do you think that I should be preparing for a data analytics question? Like in my resume, I've mentioned some algorithms like clustering, random forest, regression, R, Python. So do you think I should brush up on those points as well? Can that be asked in a business development? Because they are not technically proficient about these things. So do you think they'll be asking me about those as well?
They can, definitely, because they would not ask each and everything from your CV. They'll just pick up one or two points. It can be R, it can be Python, it can be anything. So even if you're prepared, you know almost everything in your CV, right? You know 90% of it. But if they ask you something which is in the other 10%, that is not good for you. So whatever is there in your CV, you have to be prepared for it.
Mm-hmm.
They can ask anything.
Is it like generally asked in interviews?
It depends on the interviewer. Definitely. Okay. So whatever he thinks you might not be able to answer, he'll pick up that. So be prepared with whatever you have written in your CV, because if you have written something which you haven't done, or you know, it's good. Not a good impression at all. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Anything else?
No, that's it. Thank you, ma'am.
That's it? Yeah, no problem. All the best.